So the open beta for X Defiant is coming to a close, and I played a little bit of the game. It's Ubisoft's new premier shooter that's going to release sometime this summer. I got to play quite a bit of X Defiant back when they had their first closed beta and their open beta now, so I thought I would give you guys my first impressions on X Defiant. So Tom Clancy's X Defiant is a 6v6 first-person shooter set in the Tom Clancy universe. So when it comes to the characters and factions in this game, they're loosely based off of the other known properties within Tom Clancy games. You have characters from Ghost Recon, you have the Echelons from Splinter Cell, and all of these classes have unique abilities that kind of cater to their background. So for example, Echelon class can turn invisible and use sonar to detect enemies. Now, when I first played X Defiant in the very first closed beta, there was a lot of areas of improvement I think that needed to be worked on, which definitely translate into the final product or almost final product of this game. The open beta was really fun. I liked all the tweaks and changes that they made to better the gameplay in this. X Defiant has a few game modes free to play, like Escort, which is probably one of my least favorites, to be honest. Zone Control, Domination, Occupy, and Hotshot. A lot of these game modes are pretty classic to what you would normally find in a first-person shooter like Call of Duty, for example, but the names are just tweaked a bit. In X Defiant, you're allowed to create and customize your own loadouts. This basically ranges from assault rifles to SMGs to shotguns, snipers, and marksman rifles. But let's talk about the gameplay itself. How does X Defiant feel when you're actually boots on the ground, when you're shooting enemies and running around? For the most part, it feels pretty good. I didn't find a whole lot of clunk that I experienced a little bit in the closed beta, that first release. Moving around the map is pretty fluent and fast. I didn't really have any issues with the movement. And you are able to adjust your settings and make it to where your sensitivity is just right for you. So if you want to be able to turn quickly, you can do so. I will say though, I do wish they had a few more options in regards to how like your ADS sensitivity works. I think having the ability to better fine tune in regards to like how your sense works vertically and horizontally would probably be like huge for this game. But aiming in general and shooting is not that bad. It actually feels pretty close to what you normally find in a game like Call of Duty, although the time to kill in X Defiant is a little longer, which I like. Probably one of the only things in regards to loadout that I found kind of weird when I played this game was that grenades didn't feel natural at all when you throw them. I feel as though the grenades in this game have almost like no weight to them, and when you chuck them across the map, it's like you're throwing a pebble. I think if they were to change how the physics of throwing grenades worked in this game to where it felt more like a, you know, you throwing a grenade and not accidentally tossing a rock like halfway across the map, then it would be really good. Because there were a few occasions where I thought I calculated it properly on how to throw a grenade to get it into the enemy zone, and I ended up tossing it like 15 feet past where I needed it to be. It's like most grenade throws in this game don't really have much gravity to it. Literally. I can see X Defiant being a game changer. It's a really fun game. I played with a few of my friends and we were dominating a lot of our matches. It definitely has the potential to be a good casual game as well as a good competitive game if it goes pretty far. And I think when it releases, it'll be a fairly popular game, but it just matters on whether or not it's able to retain the initial interest it's going to get when it releases, because anytime a new FPS game comes out, it's always popular. It's going to boil down to whether the core game is fun enough to play for the long term. And I think X Defiant has great potential in that regard. It's different enough to where it's kind of interesting in a new way, but also classic and familiar enough to where it won't be too daunting for new players. If you typically play a lot of first-person shooters, you won't find too many differences with X Defiant, just enough to keep it interesting, but it's familiar enough to where you can just jump into the game, learn what you need to learn in regards to how certain mechanics work, and you're off to the races. I'm curious to see if they plan to add more factions into the game to offer some more abilities. I know Ubisoft has a thing with like putting bunny things everywhere from that one game. I think it'll be laughable if they put a bunny faction in this game. Please don't actually do that, Ubisoft. It'll be great for the memes, but maybe not so much gameplay wise. Maybe their grenades could be like carrots or something, like a carrot that explodes. I will say one thing about the factions that I almost forgot to mention. Cleaners are kind of OP in a sense where they have this like passive when they shoot people and it does incendiary damage on their bullets. If you get somebody weak enough and they turn a corner, that incendiary damage from the cleaners will just cook you and kill you. I like that each faction has kind of like their thing that makes them unique, but I feel like when it comes to the cleaners, if you're going to keep incendiary damage on their gunfire, then it needs to be nerfed a little bit because it's a little too much. That, and when it comes to DedSec and those freaking spiders, if you've played through these betas, then you know what I'm talking about. The spiders need to have a different counter beyond just shooting them as they approach, because often when these matches are crazy, you don't really see it coming all the time. I think there needs to be a way for you to actually get the dang spider off of your face once it latches on, whether that be holding a button or spamming something. But the spiders are a little OP in the sense that it's hard to see them coming at times, and they stay on you for a good minute. You're stunned and it takes your health. So those two things in regards to those factions, the cleaners and the DedSec, they need some type of adjustment. Beyond that, most of the abilities in this game is fairly balanced. The guns feel pretty good. I like the array of attachments you're allowed to put on your weapons, which is really cool. You can really customize weapon to how you want it to play in game, and I think there's some really, really good combinations out there. I've had a few myself that completely dominate, in my opinion. And it'll be kind of fun to see what other kind of builds people come up with for their weapons. All in all, Tom Clancy's X-Defiant is going to be a really good game. I can guarantee you this. I plan to do a lot of content for it when it finally drops. I look forward to see what other changes they make to the game, if they are making any more changes before the game's official release, as well as what kind of content they have planned for it in the future. Will X-Defiant be a Call of Duty killer? I don't know, that's still left to be seen. I think it's a great game as it stands. We've got to see how it goes moving forward, and then we can kind of make a decision on that. But I'd love to hear your thoughts. Have you played X-Defiant, or have you maybe seen videos and trailers of it? What do you think of it so far? Let me know in the comments below. And make sure you like the video and subscribe. I'm going to be posting more X-Defiant things to come once the game officially releases. It may actually be the shooter to take me away from Apex for a while, because it is a really fun game and I like the challenge. So make sure you stay tuned here for more X-Defiant videos. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Let me know what you think of X-Defiant, and I'll see you guys on the next one.